Dear students, I made this video on the Honorable Chief Justice of Madras High Court, Justice A.P. Sahi, a great leader. I am the teacher. I have been teaching for last 35 years. Particularly for CA students, more than 2 lakh students I have taught. Right from the day one, my endeavor has always been to help the students not only achieve success in the subject, but also be a complete personality, a great leader who is useful for the society. That has been my endeavor. You may be very great leader, good successful getting rank, then you may earn lot of money. All are part of the game, but then ultimately, what service you have done to the nation? Now, to achieve the excellence, you need role models. We all need role models. Based on their behavior, their legacy, we will be able to carry forward. And then face most difficult situations of our life. If you take, for example, excellence, what is this concept of excellence? Before I come to this Honorable Chief Justice, let us take the discussion on excellence. If you want to understand the excellence, let us go to Bhagavad Gita, where Lord Krishna in Vibhuti Yogam says, Arjuna asks question, where can I see you, my lords? Where can I see you? He says, Yajnanam japa yajnosmi stavaranam himalayam. Like that it goes. That means, if you want to see me in animals, you lion. If you want to see me in mountains, I am Himalayas. If you want to see me in yajnam, japam is the highest. If you want to see me in birds, Garuda. That means, what does it infer for us is, the greatest is the excellence. The excellence is God. God is excellence. So, you also can become God by being excellent. And we wish, how to become God? How to become excellent? By seeing excellent people. And therefore, this video lecture on Mr. Sahi, Justice Sahi, to the extent I have observed, I am going to explain you. To motivate you, first let us go to the great personalities from Vedas, Lord Ram. This is very important for us. You know, Lord Ram, after killing Ravan, all the angels, gods, everybody came and they were praising Lord Ram. And Dasharatha Maharaj, the father of Ram, appeared. He tells Ram, I am in this Devlok. Everybody is praising me. Everybody is taking care of me. But my Ram, I was told, you are Swayam Sriman Narayan who have come to this earth, born as my child. It's a great thing, but I could not enjoy your company with me. For this, Lord Ram says, very important word. So far as I am concerned, I am just a human being, son of Dasharatha Maharaj. And the destiny has ordered me some duties. I am following dharma, dharmic path under all circumstances to achieve that, to perform that duties. So, those who follow the path of dharma relentlessly, path of dharma is driven by duty. So, you must remember that concept of what you are a god. If you are able to decide the perfect path and follow dharmic principles to achieve the goals. Duties and responsibilities is the concept of Ramayana. How a man should behave. The same was an inspiration. The same was an inspiration for Lord Mahatma Gandhi, Bapuji, father of nation. Now when Mahatma Gandhi started the independence, Swaraj, Sampurna Swaraj, he was always confident about his goals, that he will achieve independence to the nation. It may take 1 year, 10 years, 100 years, but then he is convinced about it. Not only the goal that he wants to achieve, and the path, that is also very, very important. So, Mahatma Gandhi continuously followed the path of non-violence, continuous perseverance, unflinching faith in the end result. And he achieved that because of the concept of Sthita Prajna, that is from Bhagavad Gita. That means you keep on doing your job, unmindful of failures or success. Success is nothing but retrying the failure. That is what you understand in all our careers. Now, let me come to the Honorable Chief Justice A.P. Sahi. And first and foremost step, you should understand the issue is about dispensation of justice. He is the judge. Honorable Madras High Court, he came last November and is due to retire in December. The Honorable Judge Edward, some health issues, and I am sure with the kind blessings of God and all of us prayers, we will come out successful. And I also feel that he will go to Supreme Court. Honorable Supreme Court will consider him as the great. It is in the interest of nation that is going to happen. I am hoping. Let us all hope. If you listen to him, anybody will think like that. First concept is dispensation of justice. You should understand the background. In dear friends, this is the part 2 of the continuing lecture video. Before we understand the greatness of this Honorable Chief Justice, we should have idea about the concept of dispensation of justice. This is a very important thing. In a justice administration system, there will be always two parties fighting each against each other. Every person thinks he is right. He may be right also. But the judge will have to give judgment in favor of one person. By giving the judgment in favor of one person, the other person will be very angry. Actually, it is very difficult for a judge to do justice. We all think this is wrong, that is wrong. But many laymen don't know what exactly. It is based on the evidence, the issues agitated before the judge, based on which only the Honorable Judge can decide. Again, justice is not like 1 plus 1 is 2. It can be 3, 4, 5. All the things are right. So the judge will have to take the best of that 3. I recollect once there was a function in which Honorable Justice M.M. Sundaresh, he is also Madras High Court, wonderful, wonderful. So I was speaking on the justice, and I took an example of Kumbhakarna and Vibhishan. Vibhishan thinks that he has done justice, he did good dharma by telling Ravan what he has done is wrong. When Ravan, he kicked him, he came to Ram, Swayam Sriman Narayan. So he tells, what I have done is right. You also come to Lord Vishnu. What is more important than surrendering to Lord Vishnu, the ultimate? Kumbhakaran will tell very beautifully, dharma is very dicey thing. What is dharma today may not be dharma tomorrow. It will change depending on time, call, everything. You thought God is important, you went. I think kulam, my kul, my brother, my generation is important. It's only time will tell who is right, who is wrong. So dharma is, you cannot say this is a straight jacket formula for dharma. And I must confess, I prepared and spoke. Then later, Honorable Justice Sundaresh came and he spoke extempore on Ramayana, Kamba Ramayana. Amazing, you know, he was not prepared, I am prepared. Seeing me, he spoke on Kamba Ramayana, extraordinarily good. That means the judges of Madras High Court are so good. I really like it because even though I am a chartered accountant, I have been appearing before this Honorable Court for the last 10 years. So, in this background and taking into consideration Madras High Court, which has the one of the best brains, anybody will tell you, most brilliant lawyers appear. One. And you know, it is a difficult bar and we had so many problems. But if you take Justice Sahi, unanimously, everybody will say is very good, is very good. For me, why I made this video is, for me, he is a guru. I learnt from him by seeing, because of the virtual hearing and also appearing before him. And I am like Ekalavya and his Dronacharya. So I thought this is the right time, he is retiring. So I have to make this video. The first and foremost step, friends, I appeared four times, four cases before this great judge. All the four he dismissed. I am telling you, all the four were dismissed. But the cases were completed within a week, two sessions. And every judgment, Honorable Justice Sendil Kumar, brother judge, he is also another god for me, and he assisted Honorable Chief. So what is that greatness I have understood is, he gives, first listens, and he tells you what he wants, very clear. He is very clear. Any case, in seconds he will come to the issue. He will just ask, this is the issue, can you speak on that? You have to be ready. He will give you time. Generally many judges criticize, particularly at different levels, they will criticize. He gives you that freedom, he listens to you, but you have to speak what he wants. And his way of understanding the facts, you know, it's a justice system is inbuilt. I have seen another adjudicating authority, NCLT, Chennai bench, Mr. Prakash Kumar, another wonderful person, he is now the president of NCLT. They have something in the blood, that subject. They know what is right, what is wrong. When the case is presented, even if the law is not there, they know this should be the law. That extent, this Honorable Justice, both of them, very brilliant, very brilliant. So I learnt, in the first case to fourth case, that I have come, all the four dismissed. But he gives relief. He gives relief. As I told you, when the justice analyzes the steps, he will see that the best is done to both the parties. He understands the grievance. He will not go to the extreme of anything. But if it comes, he will go. He doesn't care. But then, according to the settled law of jurisprudence, he does. He gives time. He is very pleasant, very kind. And I'm a lawyer. I did LLM, but the point is, I'm not a seasoned. I'm an ordinary person. But then they listen to me 1 hour. The cases. I was appearing against another advocate, Solicitor General, is a legend, is my guru, again another Shankar Narayanan. All the cases he appeared. He is such a legend. Against him. So, and you see, dear friends, his judgments. You will, the next video I am going to make, that is judgments. So that may not be useful for all the CS2 people, maybe for the lawyers. But I am talking about the greatness of this judge. In the last 10 years that I have been appearing, he is the best. All are good judges, no doubts, but he will be the best. Every lawyer I check them, they tell, oh, he's a fantastic judge. One more great thing, a chief justice of a high court is the highest court of this Tamil Nadu. He controls entire judiciary, subordinate judiciary. He will have so much of work, administrative work. Many chief justices never used to come afternoon, but he will sit up to 4 o'clock. With full concentration, with full love, he will listen. You can expect correct judgment. No fear or favor. And such a great judge, you know, normally is almost 1 month to retire. And a man of such a great excellence, he would have gone to Supreme Court long back. But somehow it didn't happen. But he never lost. You see, even today, his interest, it is called duty. This is one thing that I want to, every student should learn. Okay, you are capable to achieve something. But God might have had some other plan for you. But never lose heart. Keep doing the duty with passion. It's about passion. He took it as a service. And he has done that. And I am sure he is such a great person. Who am I? I am a small fry. But then I do have right to feel if he goes to Supreme Court, great service will be done. The cases which are taking 3 to 4 years, he finished in 2 weeks. Everybody knows. Within just 2 weeks, each petition is gone. Another petition which I filed 3 years back, not able to come and reach. He doesn't waste 1 minute also. So, therefore, I humbly pray. I'll pray the Lord Vishnu, my Hanumanji, that he comes hale and healthy and is elevated to Supreme Court. Thank you, friends.